is really hard with that Bear Gore's voice stuck in my head. I'll have to work on it later.
Did you steal my candy? No, I did not steal your candy. Did you steal my candy? No, I did not steal your candy.
Hey guys.
Why are you working with candy? Can't you see my mother? I'm sorry. Can't you see my mother? I'm sorry. Why are you working with candy? Can't you see my mother? I'm sorry. Can't you see my mother? I'm sorry. Why are you working with candy? Can't you see my mother? I'm sorry. Can't you see my mother? I'm sorry.
Oh my goodness. I'm taking a break.
You guys.
Hello, Chino. I am Halo. This is my father.
Hello, Chino. I am the King Almighty, ruler of the Heavenly Gardens.
What is this? Why am I here?
You, my boy, are going to have an excellent adventure. But first, you must come to our dinner. We have prepared not one, but two things for you.
So, how do you like your roasted turkey?
Oh, wow, it's really good.
I think mine's really good, too.
I'm glad you like my legs. Can you give me back now?
Could you?
So, King Almighty, what was that second thing you were talking about?
I'll tell you. Okay, enough of the zoom ups. We had enough of those.
Hey, Almighty, what am I fighting?
Oh, you'll find out.
Oh, man. Extremo! Are you okay? What was this about again?
My boy, there's something I must tell you.
What is it, King Almighty?
There is a dragon apocalypse. It is coming to our world to be destroyed.
Wow. Wait, this is just like something I wrote about once.
Oh my, what? Did you just say something you wrote about once?
Yeah, something I wrote about once, and my friend was writing a story and I was inspired by it.
Wow, what a coincidence. Triple or double, I don't know, big coincidence? Anyway, I wish for you to hang out with my daughter Halo, to watch upon the city, and make sure nothing goes wrong, okay?
Yes, King Almighty.
I'll do whatever we can. We will do whatever we can. Alright? Alright.
Well, everything seems to be going pretty well. I think. Especially when there's no one around except for that little family down there with just a dad and their... his four kids.
What makes you nervous a lot?
I don't know. Maybe, There's just something about, Well... I don't know why Almighty would want me to be with you.
I know a reason, but you're not supposed to find out yet.
Well, can I at least say it first? Come on, children. We don't want to be caught in this mess. Let's go.
Run away! Run away! Run away!
Oh no. Four deaths. I shall slay the beast. Huh? That was easy.
It's easy for you to say.
Now, Halo, Extremo, I know the last mission wasn't so easy for you because you couldn't spot the dragons, but I have a much harder one for you, and I know this sounds ironic because the last one would have sounded more easy if this one wasn't so hard. But it will be. I don't know if any of that made sense to you, but listen. You're going to have to slay the Dragon King. It doesn't sound as easy as it sounds. We're in! Wait a minute! Oh well. Okay, we're here. We need to... Oh dear. Give it up, Dragon King. You're not gonna rule Heavenly Gardens.
Oh, yes, I will. And it'll cost you your life and all of your friends. Ah! I've gotten your friend, and now you will be next.
Oh no, I forgot my weapons.
Did you say weapons? I got your weapons.
How'd you get them?
The dragon from the attack on the town. Got them!
Oh. You'll have to take me in order to get her. Take what's coming to you. Must get weapon. Oh, there it is. Oh, I can't reach it. Oh, God. Where? How can I get out now? Everybody, what happened?
You're still in Heavenly Gardens.
That's okay. I like it here. I just hope I get to visit home sometimes. Don't worry, my boy. You will.
On December 7th, 1941, Japan, like its infamous Axis partners, struck first and declared war afterwards. Costly to our Navy was the loss of war vessels, airplanes, and equipment, but more costly to Japan was the effectiveness of its foul attack in immediately unifying America in its determination to fight and win the war thrust upon it, and to win the peace that will follow. The Japs copied their German masters in striking hard at airfields, Hickam Field, northwest of Honolulu, and the Ford Island Naval Plane Base were the first objectives of Japan's treachery. Scores of planes were bruised and battered by the Japs' aerial bombs. Many of these were demolished beyond repair. Direct hits were scored on hangars, and these were badly shattered. Equipment and airplane supplies were reduced to smoldering ruins. Here at the Naval Air Station is grim and positive evidence of Jap treachery. Here, foul blows were struck, while Jap diplomats were talking peace in Washington. America lost three destroyers. Here are seen the United States destroyers Downs and Shaw as they rest on the bottom of Pearl Harbor with decks awash after Jap bombers make direct hits on their decks. First to feel the sting of Japanese steel are the USS Oklahoma and Utah, the latter a 33-year-old target ship. Accurate hits by the enemy bombers make short work of these two naval bulwarks. Now with their keels practically out of water, they lie helpless wrecks and a sad reminder of cowardly strategy. To make possible a surprise attack within Pearl Harbor, the Japs built two-man submarines to enable them to fire sneak blows within waters that are narrow and tortuous. Several of these surprise weapons were blown from the water by direct hits of our naval gunners. Others were beached and captured. While sky and sea fire was still raging, salvage crews inspected our naval craft to estimate what may be saved. Before the din of bursting bombs had been silenced, preparations were underway to salvage these two warships. At low tide, the huge propeller of the Oklahoma, stilled by the enemy, was high above water. It is believed that the small two-man Jap submarines carrying dual torpedo tubes were responsible for these two losses to our Pacific Fleet. Here is the actual bombing of the mighty USS Arizona by Jap planes. These pictures were made by a fearless cameraman who thought nothing of his personal safety to make possible this record for all posterity. A single lucky hit was responsible for the disaster that befell the Arizona when a Jap bomb falling directly through one of the battleship's funnels exploded in the engine room and set ablaze tons of fuel oil. Dense black smoke billowed to the sky as the massive control tower began to keel over. The Arizona's courageous crew stuck to its guns until the very end. Here was displayed heroism that will live forever in the glorious annals and traditions of the American Navy. The once mighty Arizona now rests on Pearl Harbor's muddy bottom. A pitiful relic of its former self, a grim monument to the treachery of Japan. The once mighty dreadnought's armor plate is twisted and torn, but the great battleship's control tower still stands, a defiant beacon that in days to come will cast its shadow upon Nippon's very shores. At Pearl Harbor, at Hickam Field, in the bomb-pocked streets of Honolulu, ever is written history. History with a tragic, treacherous pen. History that 130 million Americans will never forget. And in days to come, the Japs, too, will remember Pearl Harbor. Here is a tragic, unforgettable page in the annals of America. Here, the cunning deceit of the Japs will never be forgotten. Here, they hoped to score a knockout before the war began. The Arizona's gun crews, battered and broken, fired to the last. Their guns pointed skyward from whence the enemy appeared. The Jap sneak blow cost hundreds of military and civilian lives. The treacherous attack cost our Pacific Fleet two battleships outright, another capsized, the loss of three destroyers and a mine layer. While bombs were still bursting and flames still pouring from our shattered naval craft, a light United States cruiser valiantly moves out to join the fleet and avenge Pearl Harbor. June 3rd, 1935. The Normandy, $60 million luxury liner, comes to America on its maiden crossing of the Atlantic, an event that occasioned a marine demonstration that will live in history. Whistles blew and sirens shrieked a mighty welcome to the new Queen of the Seas. The famed skyline of America's greatest city formed a fitting background for America's greeting to one of the most stately ships that ever crossed the Atlantic. 6 years later, shortly after the United States entered the war, the Normandy was seized and placed under naval guard. Hundreds of civilian workers were put aboard the Normandy, renamed the USS Lafayette, to strip the vessel of its costly furnishings and to prepare it for war duty as a United States transport. February 9th, 1942, the Normandy afire. A fatal tragedy to the big luxury liner and to America. As the flames rapidly spread to devastating fury, workers madly scrambled to safety, while fireboats and fire engines poured tons of water into the stricken vessel. All fire doors, vertical and horizontal, were closed to protect the ship's vitals from the flames, but this was all in vain. Dense clouds of thick, acrid smoke billowed far out over Manhattan, casting a mucky pall over Midtown and downtown New York. While the blaze was at its height, hundreds of doctors, nurses, and first aid workers were rushed to the scene to remove the wounded and to administer first aid to scores overcome in their efforts to stem the fury of the spreading flames. Millions stood in awe when the Normandy first reached America on its triumphant maiden voyage. Again, millions lined the New York and New Jersey shores to sadly observe the passing of the doomed and ill-fated ship. Rear Admiral Adolphus Andrews, Commandant of the 3rd Naval District, ordered all hands ashore to save the lives of those who were heroically battling to keep the huge liner upright. Hour after hour, tons of water were pumped into the Normandy, causing a bad list to port as strong hawsers snapped and tugs strove to push the giant vessel close to the wharf. Then, during the night, the Normandy met its final doom when, with a resounding crunch of ice and a belch of smoke, the 83,000-ton vessel dipped her flame-scarred superstructure into the surface of the Hudson River. Hundreds were injured when America lost its biggest naval auxiliary. Millions of dollars of damage has been done, and thousands of man-hours of labor have been nullified. Accident or sabotage, the world may never know. But the fate of the luxury liner Normandy, rechristened the USS Lafayette, is one of the major catastrophes of our day.
Everyone's familiar with World War II. The tanks. The bombing. Tragedies and attacks, but the only thing that was never revealed to anyone was the moment when Missile Man was born. Let's see, Ultron, Magnum, it works, yeah, this part is working, and let's see if it works, yeah. Let's see if this works now.
I hope it does, because it'll save America from World War II.
Halo, I am Missile Man. I need someone to wear me for good use.
Good use. I wonder if that soldier Warren Fitzgerald will be able to wear it. I'll have to get authority to give me permission.
Mr. Fitzgerald, it is important that you listen to me. I am a scientist that built this machine of a suit to save the United States from ultimate disaster.
Hey, what do you want me to do about it?
I'm assigning you to become a hero.
Hero. Hero. Hero.
It's been a long time since I've been a hero, but I'll gladly accept your offer.
Now have a drink. No thanks. Darn.
General Feister's base to destroy General Feister's island where he stores his ultimate nuclear bomb is on this island.
Now, I want you, in this suit,
to...
What are you doing?
Saying hello. Ah, that's nice. Get out of the way. What I want you to do is just go in there and steal the bomb and detonate it in outer space. Or probably something much safer than that, but...
Anyway, have fun, but just be careful in there. It's really dangerous.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Wait. Did I just say it twice?
No, that's just your installed, friend. Say hello to it. Say hello to your little friend.
Okay. Hello.
Hello.
That's a very small island. Wait. It's an undersea island. It's very bigger than it seems. Okay, just gotta sneak around here and... Okay, just gotta sneak on here and... Looking for someone? Huh? Who said that? What the heck are you?
I'm General Feister.
What the heck happened to you? Why do you look like corn? It's very corny.
Years ago, when I was making the ultimate nuclear bomb, my skin mutated and looked like corn. It's very corny, isn't it? And I am sure that joke will get old soon, so let's stop with that, okay?
Okay, then.
Hi-ya!
Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-
Missile Man, there's one thing you forgot. The bomb.
What?
My name is Hutch Starstone, and these are my weapons. I'm glad you came here in time to see them. I will use this large gun on these monster aliens. As you will see, these spies were sent to destroy me, but they are nothing against this large alien laser gun that I have produced right here. Fire! That took care of things. Holy goodness, who the heck are you?
I am Fistful, a fistful of metal.
Where you come from?
I have come to punch you in the face.
Not this time, pal. I will laser you if you don't tell me where your creator is. Fine. I shall join you on your quest. I must tell you a secret. My creator actually abuses me. I shall have to join you because of that reason. Good to know.
Alright, new friend. Where do we find this creature of yours?
Well, he is beyond this mountain.
This mountain?
Ha! You have betrayed me, Fistful. I shall taser you.
Hey, what's going on? Why am I here?
Welcome aboard. My name is Captain Liverpool, and you're here with the Dream Pirates.
There's only one of you.
It's just an act, my boy. Play along. I challenge you to a fight.
Yeah.
Very clever of an attack, but you'll never face my bottle.
Oh, hey, stop that. Hey, hey, stop that. I think you get the point. Can we please call the truce? I think I'm ready for the next challenge.
Okay. This is Sugarcane Island. As you can see, there is a sugar bird over there willing to say hello. Say hello.
Hello. Tweet tweet. Tweet tweet tweet. Oh no! That sugarcane bird got attached! I'll save you. That was easy.
Good job, my boy. All you have to do next is
what?
Boy, my plan's gone out of hand. I was trying to tell you, you had parents. You must rescue your parents!
You gotta be around here somewhere. Mom! Dad! It's you!
You've come for us, Sonny boy!
Congrats for finding us!
Oh no! This thing!
We gotta get it dead before it kills us.
I'll save you.
Oh, thanks, Sonny boy.
Yeah, thanks a lot.
But how we get home? We're stuck in this dream world.
We'll find a way. Or maybe we'll just have this be our home for temporary.
Yeah.
Oh dear.
guys. Need any help?
Don't worry about us, Ben. Continue working on your story. You deserve it.
Okay, then.